Hi there, folks. Welcome to the web. We begin in Concord, where an early morning fire ripped through a truck storage building with the flames lighting up the night sky. Thanks for joining us once again here on the web. I'm Josh McElveen. The cause is under investigation, but this is what is left behind of a facility behind Yankee Kenworth Trucks. Our Ray Brewer was on the scene and explains the dangerous conditions that firefighters had to face.
It was the explosions, just popping left and right. I just stayed in bed and listened to them for a while, trying to figure out what they were.
It turned out those explosions were coming from a storage building at Yankee Kenworth in Concord. The building was approximately 300 feet long, containing truck parts and several vehicles.
Looked out the window and it was like it was daylight. Flames were about 40 feet high.
Steve Roby says he woke up his neighbor because he was concerned about the fire spreading. The fire would go to three alarms, bringing in every Concord firefighter and firefighters from about a dozen other communities. Those firefighters managed to keep the fire from spreading.
And they had the guy on the big ladder up there, and then a couple of like little portable hoses that they seemed to have it pretty well contained at that point.
The chief says they were worried about the gasoline tanker parked next to the building, even though it was empty. And there were other problems.
This is a trucking company. The yard is full of large vehicles. It's a little after hours, so it's a pretty full yard, and just being able to maneuver around, navigate around those vehicles, set up our equipment, get the water supply, and go to work. It had a few challenges this morning.
Fortunately, there were no injuries, and the fire was under control around 3:30 in the morning. In the daylight, the search for the cause got underway, but investigators say this was a big building, and it's going to take some time.
The owner of the company says that his suppliers have already been in touch and have assured him that they will get him all the parts that he needs, so the loss of the building should not really affect the business. That's good news there. Police in Manchester are investigating an early morning stabbing. They say a person was stabbed in the shoulder and head just before 8:30 at a home on Aaron Drive. The victim now recovering at the hospital. At this time, though, police are not releasing any information about what happened or if any arrests have been made. And a search is going on for an armed robber in Goffstown. Shortly after 9:30 last night, police say this man walked into the Cumberland Farms on Mass Road, showed a gun to the clerk, and demanded cash and cigarettes. Suspect is described as a Hispanic man, 5'6" to 5'8". Anyone with any information is being asked to call the police in Goffstown. And after a vote yesterday to kill the proposal, House lawmakers in Concord will reconsider a bill that would allow two casinos in New Hampshire after all. Yesterday's vote to keep the bill open for more debate ended in a tie, so the acting House Speaker broke that tie, voting to kill the bill. But today, a motion was filed just before the noon deadline to reconsider Senate Bill 366. This is a debate that will take place next week. And marathon bombing survivor Jeff Bowman is doing a book signing in Concord tonight. Bowman's new book, Stronger, details the face-to-face encounter that he had with Tamerlan Tsarnaev and the daily struggles and how grateful he is to the people who saved his life. He will be signing copies at the library tonight at 7 o'clock. And starting tonight at 5, we're live at TD Garden, where the Bruins will be facing off against the Montreal Canadiens to kick off the Stanley Cup playoffs round 2. And Easy Pass customers should take a look at their statements, at least a close look. We'll tell you which toll plaza has been accidentally overcharging drivers. Be safe. Have a great afternoon.